Assalamu alaikum students, lecture number 3 on sequences of IGCSE Mathematics 0580. We are still doing topical past papers of 2021, and now the discussion will be on the geometric sequences. Your instructor Abdul Rafi here. This is a 3-mark question again, in which we have to find the end term of each sequence. So we'll focus on from here onwards, that is this thing, that is 2/1, 3/4, 4/16, 5/64, 6/256. Okay, so students need to understand, you have to get the term formula here, the end term as well here. But before solving this one, students need to be very clear that understand the importance of when you have this type of sequences being tested in the exam, there can be two different sequences going on in the numerator and denominator. Okay, so that is why it's very careful to understand this is a complete different dynamic question. So that's a past paper question, and very important to understand the whole chapter overview and content on this. So students need to understand that in the numerator, as we can see, there is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, which means that, let's write it down here, that if it is 2, then we have 3, then we have 4, then we have 5, and then we have 6. This means that this is definitely a linear one. So we can say that in numerator, they are applying the linear sequence, okay? That is basically because plus 1 added here, okay? Similarly, you have plus 1 added here, you have plus 1 added here, you have plus 1 added here, okay, students? So that is very important that plus 1 is being added, okay? So you can find this very quickly through the linear sequence, that is 2+1, 3. So you've just find out a plus n minus 1d, and the other way of finding is very simple. This is the first term, this is the second term, this is the third term, fourth term, and fifth term. So you can judge directly as well, each term is adding plus 1 into it, okay? So you can say that in the numerator, the following, this is being followed, okay? N plus 1 is being followed, whatever the term is. If it's the second term, 2+1 gives us 3. If it's the third term, 3+1 gives us 4. If it's the fourth term, 4+1 gives us 5. So you can just write down. So half of the answer is done here, students, when you write n+1 in the numerator, because numerator is following this sequences, this term, okay? N term for the numerator is n+1. And you can do it the other way as well by saying that the common difference is +1, okay? So let's write down that the common difference is 1 and the first term is 2, right? Because the first term is 2, let me do the highlighter. So everyone gets this, the first term is 2 and the common difference is 1, okay? Students, hope everyone gets this, that the common difference is 1. So it will be a plus, by now you should be memorizing the formula, a plus 1 n minus 1 d. So 2 plus n minus 1 times 1. So here we go, 2 plus n minus 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1. So 1 plus n or n plus 1 is the formula that is already written there, okay? So hope students get this. But what about, this was not the main part. The main thing is, what about the denominator, okay? What about the denominator? So in denominator, I'm doing it with a different highlighter color. You need to follow what's happening here, okay? You need to follow what's happening here. This is the denominator. It's not a linear sequence. It's not a quadratic sequence. It's not even a cubic sequence as well. It is called a geometric sequence, okay? So let me write this down as well. It is called a geometric sequence. Those who do add maths will be able to easily get this, capture this, okay? So let me write down the denominator, that is 1, 4, and 16, and 64, and 256, okay? 64 and 256. And how do I judge this directly, that it's a geometric sequence, without wasting my time whether to find out, okay, whether this is linear, quadratic, cubic? I'm judging this because all of them are multiples of 4, okay? When you multiply 4 4s are 16, 16 4s are 64, 64 times 4 is 256, and 1 times 4 is 4. So when you have a common multiplication or the division rule, it is called a geometric sequence, okay, students? It is called a geometric sequence. questions. Also for your satisfaction when you start practicing, because if you are new to this chapter, first you try to do it the same way that I've taught you, try to find out the differences, but it will not work it out, okay? You find out the differences that this is plus 3, this is plus 12, and then this is plus 9, okay? And then some, you go on, you will not be able to find out, okay? You can do this, okay, let's do it. Let's do this as well for students' understanding. This is plus 3, this is plus 12, okay? This is something, 64 minus 16, we call this 48, so 16 plus 48, okay? And just try this one, 12 and 48, so 48 minus 12, that gives us 36, okay? And it will still not match, okay? You're getting my point, hope everyone is getting my point. It will not match for even quadratic, neither cubic, okay? So hope students get this. 256 minus 64. So you can judge based on that as well. It will never match, okay? Hope people get this, that it will not match. Not linear, no quadratic, no cubic. It is geometric because of the multiplication and the division thing. So what is the formula for the geometric sequence? Everything is based on formula, students. The formula, the term formula is AR power n minus 1, okay? It is AR power n minus 1. Again, we'll write down that where A is the first term, okay? We'll write down here that A is the first term and R is the common ratio, okay? So R is basically the common ratio, okay? So there is no common difference here. R is basically called the common ratio. Just like we find the difference, the common difference is the next term minus the previous term, or the second term minus the first term. Common ratio is basically the next term minus the previous term. We have R, that is the common ratio, and the formula for common ratio is the next term divided by the previous term, okay? So the formula for the common ratio is next term divided by the previous term, okay, students? So that's what you have to do here. Simply, you are going to say that it's going to be, the value of A is already known, the value of A is 1, okay? That is very simple and clear. Let me write it down here. The value of A is 1, sir. It's very simple because A is the first term. Always the first term is represented like this, that A is 1, sir. We are talking about the ratio. We have to work about the ratio. So how do you get the ratio, sir? Here we go, students, okay? It's the ratio. It's the next term divided by the first term. So it will be 4 divided by 1, 16 divided by 4, 64 divided by 16, okay? Or 256 divided by 64, all of them will result in the R value, common ratio as 4, okay? So if you see, I have done here what, sir? Sir, you have done basically the second term divided by first term, or the third term divided by second term, or the fourth term divided by the third term, or the fifth term divided by the fourth term. It's the next term you take divided by the previous term. If all of them are giving a common ratio, common number, it means it is a geometric sequence. Hope students get this, because this is what this thing talks about. Next term divided by previous term, if you get the same answer, that is common ratio, and that is called a geometric sequence, okay? So here in our case, it was 4 divided by 1 is also 4. If you divide 64 by 16, that is also 4. So here you go, students. The answer will be the term formula 1, that is A, okay, times of the ratio, that is 4, power n minus 1, okay? Ratio for n minus 1. So here we go. The final answer will be 4 n plus 1. In the numerator, we have a linear sequence, and in the denominator, we have a geometric sequence. That is how this can be complicated, and this is one of the, this can be one of the tricky questions for students to understand, but this is the answer. And as I always say, it doesn't matter which type of sequence is this. Just recheck, because you have the option of rechecking. So make sure you recheck, students, okay? So let's say term number 4, is term number 4 coming 64? So let's check this out. Term number 4, 1 times 4 power 4 minus 1. So here we go, 4 power 3, and 4 power 3 is 4 into 4 into 4. Definitely it's coming 64, okay? So 4 minus 1 in the power makes us 3, and 4 power 3 is 64, sir. So here we go. This is 100% proof, and this is going to be our answer, students. Linear divided by a geometric sequence. That's how geometric sequences work, okay? So hope students get this and everyone is clear on this learning and understanding of geometric sequences as well.